No, pero...
Wow. For those of you tuning in at home, we are currently throwing Scooby Snacks around the room, and we're not doing very well with it. Alright, so, did you catch it?
I got it.
That's a catch!
That's so many.
That's a catch! Okay? So we got a little bit of a warm-up, and then we've got, we'll go on to Q6, which is talking about determinants, kind of a big deal. Determinants, we're gonna utilize them to, you know, go forward with the algebra. And we're gonna get the Cramer's rule tomorrow, too. Yesterday, we took the EMPT. If you did not take the EMPT, log on to Canvas, and there should be a sheet on there with these instructions that are up here on the board on how to take that test. It'll take you about 45 minutes, and it's not graded, but it's good. Remember, EMPT stands for Early Math Placement Test. It's what the UW system uses to place you into the math. So, warm it up, Chris. I'm about to warm it up, Chris. You'll understand that. You'll understand that song here in a minute. A times B. Can I multiply A times B?
No.
No, can't do it. A is a 2x2 matrix. B is a 3x2 matrix. So I cannot because those two middle numbers per are not the same, so that be not possible. Can I multiply B times A?
Yes.
Yes, that I can do because this is a 2x2. And by the way, 3x2. I was doing it the same way again. A 3x2 by a 2x2, and those two right there are yes, and that leaves me with a 3x2 matrix. So I'm going to take the first row, first row times the first column, so that's going to be 3 times 2 plus 1 times 7. And then that's going to be 3 times 3 plus 1 times negative 4. And then I'm going to take the second row, and that's going to be 5 times 2 plus 0 times 7. And then I'm going to take 5 times 3 plus 0 times negative 4. And then I'm going to take the third row, and that's going to be negative 2 times 2. Plus 5 times 7, and then that's going to be negative 2 times trace plus 5 times negative 4. Then I'm going to do that math. Well, that math tells me that this is 6 plus 7, so that's going to be 13. This math over here tells me this is 9 plus negative 4. That tells me that that's going to be 5. No. This one over here tells me it's 5 times 2 is 10. 5 times 3 is 15. Negative 4 plus 35 is 31. Negative 6 plus negative 20 is negative 26. Do we agree with that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. 13, 5, 10, 15, 31, negative 26. Good to go. Love it.
Oh.
Love it.
All right. So, new vocab word today is a determinant. Okay? A determinant boils an entire matrix down to one value. It's kind of like assigning a points system to a matrix, except the points mean nothing. Okay? It gives it one value. We're going to use this determinant when we go to solve systems of equations using matrices. There's a couple of different ways to do that. But we got to know first rule of the determinant is that the matrix that you are trying to determine and needs to be a square matrix. If it is not a square matrix, it does not have a determinant. So it has to have equal rows and columns. 2 by 2, 3 by 3, 4 by 4, and 8 by 9. And all of those have determinants. We're going to focus in on 2 by 2 and 3 by 3s. There's technology out there that allows you to go bigger, faster. 2x2s, faster in your brain. 3x3s, we'll show you how to do it. Okay? Good? All right, let's start with a 2x2. Okay? So a 2x2 is, so first off, the symbol for determinant is DET. And that's the only symbol is DET. And then you could say, if you've got a name for it, you could say like DET of B, you know, capital matrix B, and so on and so forth. Okay? So you could do that. But it's a simple rule that will make you want to jump. Okay? So there's a reason that, now it's going to probably play an ad, too. Come on, no? Play for me. There we go. It's a domain ad. We got to go through the Grammarly ad.
Just click on the highlight.
Infinite. Here we go. Crisscross. Okay? So crisscross is played the same. If they wore all their clothes backwards.
That you never had. I make you bump, wiggle and shake your rump. Cause I be kicking the flavor that makes you wanna jump. How high, real high, cause I'm just so fly. A young, lovable, huggable type of guy. And everything is to the back with a little slack. Cause inside out is wiggle, 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 whack. I come stopping with some
pump and make you jump. Alright.
Yeah, it is.
So, escape. Back to this one, hey. Okay? So, because that's a catchy song. You've heard it before. You probably boogied down to it before. Okay? Because it's wiggity, 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 whack. Okay? So Criss Cross is the people that sing that song. Okay? Criss Cross is the name of the group. Okay? So what you do to find the value of a determinant is you take the Criss. Okay? So you multiply the Chris's together. So this is A times D. And then you minus the cross. So then it's minus C times B. Okay? Every time. It's crisscross makes you want to jump. Okay? Alright? How high? Real high. Okay?
So if
it's
like a 3x3,
it would be. We'll get to it. But it's still crisscross makes you wanna jump. Okay? Okay? That's it for a 2x2. Crisscross makes you wanna jump. Okay? Let's do it, man. Okay? Now, the other symbol for determinant that's not a word is straight sides. Almost like absolute values of the matrix. Or of the matrix, I should say. Okay? Okay? That's the other symbol. So DET or straight side, not brackets. Okay? All Here we go. So we've got the Chris. So that's going to be 3 times 1 minus the cross minus 6 times negative 2. 3 times 1 is 3 minus negative 12. The value of this determinant is 15. I wish it looked more complicated, but it's not. Crisscross makes you want to jump, jump. Okay. Now, when you get to a 3x3 determinant, now it gets a little bit more complicated, but not really. Okay. So first thing is, it's got to be square again. Okay, so a 3x3, we're all good. The first thing that you're going to do is you are going to rewrite columns 1 and 2. Okay? So you're going to rewrite column 1. Here, hold on 1 second. Let me move this up. Move that up. Okay? So when I go to rewrite columns 1 and 2, I'm going to go 4, negative 2, 1, 1, 2, 5. That's rewriting columns 1 and 2. Got it? Yes. Luckily, you have nice friends in here that do.
Actually,
Miss
Hillman told me.
Oh, okay. That works, too. Good with me so far. Good so far? Okay. All right. Now, here's where the Chris's come. Okay? So now you've got your Chris's. Chris.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I should have made
it. And you multiply all of those together. So it is 4 times 1 times 3 plus negative 2 times negative 2 times 2 plus 0 times 1 times 5. And then it's minus the crosses. Cross, cross, cross. So that's minus 2 times 1 times 0 minus 5 times negative 2 times 4 minus 3 times 1 times negative 2.
So you add the Chris's together.
Add the Chris's minus the crosses. Always Chris minus cross. Makes you want to jump, jump. Okay? So then this would be 12 plus 8 plus 0 minus 0 minus negative 40 minus negative 6. 12 plus 8 is 20 minus negative 40 is 60. Minus negative 6 is 66. Crisscross makes you want to jump, jump. Hmm. You try that one on your own. Zero. Negative 8 is negative 24. Negative 11, positive 13, 10. I get 10. Yes, on the 10? Yeah? Okay. Now, here's the cool thing. We can also use determinants to find the area of a triangle given the coordinates of the three vertices of the triangle. And that formula is the area of our triangle is equal to 1/2 the determinant of the matrices. Yeah? Now, you may be saying to yourself, self, how am I going to get a square matrix out of 6 elements? Like, you know, the rows got to equal columns. Okay? So here is how. So we take, and the best part about this whole thing, because of how the determinants are found, okay? It doesn't matter which point you take first and which point you take. Okay? So my matrix, let's call it matrix T here for triangle, my matrix is going to be 2, negative 3, 4, 0, and negative 6, 5. Okay? But remember, it's got to be a square matrix. So I've got to add a whole nother column. And in that column, I'm just going to add ones. Because multiplying by one doesn't change the value. Okay. So now, if we find the determinant of that, and I multiply that by half, then we've got what we need to get. 2 times 0 times 1 is 0. Negative 3 times 1 times negative 6 is positive 18. 1 times 4 times 5 is 20. Then we've got the crosses. Negative 6 times 0 times 1 is 0. 5 times 1 times 2 is 10. 1 times 4 times negative 3 is negative 12. +20 = 38 - 10 = 28 + 12 = 40 times 1/2 is 20. The area of our triangle is 20 square units. Agree? Good. Good.
You can continue working upon your packet. You can start now in the Q6 stuff. We will pick up on this more tomorrow.
Right there.
Is this it, please, Janet?
Mm-hmm.
This is it. But,